Assalamualaikum and good day. In this video, we will focus on Miller indices of a plane. We will look at on how to determine crystal plane indices. Generally, there are three steps on how to determine crystal plane indices. The first step is we need to determine where the crystal plane intersects at the three axes. If the plane is parallel to an axis, it is given an intersection as infinity. The second step that we need to do is take the reciprocal of the three integers found in step one. The last step is we just need to label the plane as HKL with a bracket like this. To make it easier, we will use this table to find our crystal plane indices. For us to better understand the steps, I will try to do this example. What we are going to do now is we want to find the crystal plane indices for this plane. First step is we need to write down the table that we have looked before. We write down axis, x, y, and z, and then interception, after that reciprocals, reduction, and the last one enclosed. Now we look at the intersection. On the plane over here, the plane intercept at 1 over 2 at x axis. So we write down 1 over 2. At y axis, the plane intersects at 1. And then at the z axis, the plane intersects at 1 over 2. Now we do the reciprocals for all three interceptions. Reciprocals for 1 over 2 will become 2 over 1. Reciprocal for 1 is 1 over 1. And lastly, reciprocal for 1 over 2 is 2 over 1. So for 2 over 1, we can write down 2 only. 1 over 1, we can write down 1. For the reduction, we need to make a reduction when we have a fraction. Over here, we now have integer. So we just use the integer. Lastly, for the important part, we make the enclosed. Please remember the enclosed shape must be like this. This is the flow for example 1. And this is the answer. For first example, we use the origin is at 0 over here. For crystal plane indices, the origin might be changed to other location depending on the question and situation. Now we are going to look at example number 2. For example number 2, the plane is over here. The plane is not intercept at y axis, so we need to find a new axis by using new origin. If we use the original origin over here, the plane did not intersect at y axis. So we will get infinity. We need to find a new origin so that we have less or no infinity. For example, in this case, we can use this point as the new origin so that the plane intersects in x direction, also intersect in y direction, and intersect in z direction. Please bear in mind, for the x and z direction, the plane intersect at negative value. Finding new origin only occurs in crystal plane indices. It did not happen in crystal direction indices. For direction indices, we just use the original origin. Now we are going to solve the example 2. We write down axis, x, y, z, interceptions, reciprocals, reduction, and enclosed. Now we check all the intersection that occurs by using origin over here, our new origin. In x axis, the intersect is negative 1. For y axis, the intersect is 1. And in the z direction, intersect at negative 1. The reciprocal will be negative 1, 1, and negative 1. So for the reduction, we have an integer, so we let it be as integer as negative 1, 1, and negative 1. And lastly, for enclose, we must use this bracket, and then we write down 1 bar for the negative value, 1 and 1 bar. All the negative value must have an over bar like this on top of the value. Second example is to show you how you are going to change your origin. Later, we will look at other cases in example 3. You guys can pause the video to check the answer here. For the third example, you can see that the plane is parallel to Z axis. This is the plane. Even though we change the origin from here to another place, such as here, the plane still parallel to Z axis. We can try to change to over here, but still, the plane is parallel to Z axis. For this case, we just use the original axis and give the Z as infinity. As usual, we start by write down axis, X, Y, Z, intercept, reciprocal, reduction, and enclose. For X axis, the plane intersect at 1. For Y axis, the plane intersect at 1. And for the Z axis, the plane did not intersect, but it is parallel to Z axis. So we write down infinity. Reciprocal for 1 is 1, reciprocal for 1 is 1, and reciprocal for infinity is 1 over infinity is equal to 0. So we write down 0. For the reduction, we just write down 1, 1, 0, because there is no fraction. So for enclose, as usual, we make this bracket, and then we write down 1, 1, 0 as the final answer. So for the third example, please remember, if we have parallel, we can try to change the origin. If not, we use infinity where the axis parallel with plane. Now we are going to look at example 4. In example 4, we have two problems. The first problem is the plane did not intersect at our original x axis. So what we need to do, we need to find a new origin so that the plane intersect in x direction. For this case, I will use the origin over here so that the plane will intersect in x direction. I label the new origin as origin prime or 0 prime. The second problem is the plane is parallel to y axis. We already changed the origin, so we are going to write down infinity at y axis. As usual, write down axis, x, y, z, intercept, reciprocal, reduction, and enclose. Interception at x axis is 1. Write down 1. Intersection at y axis is infinity. There is no interception at y axis. So we write down infinity. For z axis, the intersection is over here. To get the actual value after we change the origin, we need to subtract 5 over 6 at this point minus with 1 over 3 to get the actual value intersection at z. 5 over 6 minus 1 over 3 will be 1 over 2. For reciprocal, 1 will be 1 infinity will be 0, 1 over 2 will become 2. For reduction, the same as before, we don't have fraction, so we just write down 1, 0, 2. And for enclosed, please remember again, the bracket is like this. We write down 1, 0, 2. This is the final answer. Once again, you can pause the video so that you can check your answer. For the fifth example, we can see that the plane passed through original origin over here. We need to find a new origin. I will use this new origin. I will label it as origin prime. Please start by writing down axis, x, y, z, intercept, reciprocal, reduction, and enclose. By using the new origin, the intersection at x did not happen. So we write down as infinity because it is parallel to x axis. From the new origin, the plane intersects at negative 1 in y axis. For z axis, the plane intersects at 1 over 2. The reciprocals will be 0, negative 1, and 2. Reduction is 0, negative 1, and 2. Enclosed will be 0, 1 bar, and 2. This is our final answer. For our last example, example 6, the plane is parallel with z and x. We cannot change the new origin over here because the plane will cross the new origin. If we change the origin to here or here or here, the plane is still parallel to x and z axis. So we will maintain the origin as original one. When we use the original origin over here, the plane is parallel through x axis, so we use infinity. For y axis, the plane intersects at 1. At z direction, also infinity, because the plane did not intersect anywhere in the axis over here. After that, we solve the reciprocal as 0 for infinity, 1 and 0. Reduction 0, 1, 0. And enclosed will be 0, 1, 0. This is our final answer. Please pause this video to check your answer. In your note, there are exercises you can do. Please do the exercise to make you understand it further. Sometimes you need to draw the following Miller indices plane that been given. In this case, you need to reverse the steps that I told you before. We will try to solve for A. We start by writing down the Miller indices plane given. In this case, we start from bottom until top. For reduction, maintain 2, 0, 1. For reciprocal, you can maintain 2, 0, 1. From reciprocal to intercept, you need to do reciprocal again in this value. So over here will be 1 over 2. Over here will be 1 over 0. Over here will be 1 over 1. 1 over 2 at x axis means that the plane is intersect at 1 over 2. 1 over 0 means infinity. It means that the plane did not intersect at y axis. 1 over 1 is 1. It means that the plane intersects at 1 for z axis. So your answer will get like this after you draw your Miller indices plane, where the plane intersects at 1 over 2 in x axis. It did not intersect anywhere in y axis, and it intersects at 1 in z axis. Please try to do the rest of the exercise here. That's all for me for Miller indices of a plane. As usual, you can ask me or your lecturers if you have any problem regarding to Miller indices of a plane. Thank you and have a good day.